During our crossover service into 2023, I preached a message entitled God Specializes in Comebacks. I want you to believe that in this year, you will begin to experience your comeback in your life, in your business, in your career. You shall rise again. I say you shall rise again. It is a message that I preach at the CTCM convention. The Apostle General Yaningwale gave us a scripture upon which we must minister to the members. Micah 7 verse 8. Do not laugh at me, my enemies, when I fall, for I shall arise. When I am in darkness, before you know it, the Lord will bring me to his light. I declare this morning that you shall rise again. Those who wrote you off, rejected you, denied opportunities, are about to see your rising. I say they're about to see your rising. I say they're about to see your rising. We declared 2023 leading to 2026, when our church turns 40, the season to rebuild. And I thank God that I'm alive to witness what God is about to do in you, through you, and for you. I want to declare to you this morning that best days are ahead of you. I don't know whether you believe it. I say best days are ahead of you. I don't know whether you believe it. If you believe it, rise on your feet and celebrate that best days are ahead of you in your life, in your business, in your career. Best days are ahead of you. Please take your seats. God gave me a clear mandate for 2023 that I have to obey as a leader. He told me to mobilize the church to pray and to fast. He told me to mobilize the church to pray and to fast. The problems of South Africa need more prayer than strategy. Amen. They need more prayer than strategy. Mama O will tell you, Mama Tuli knows, because she was part of the church when we started, that we prayed more than we preached. I say we prayed more than we preach. And God is saying to us again, let us pray more than we preach. My ministry in 2023 will be more focused on prayer and fasting. Jesus says, my house shall be a house of prayer. Say, my house shall be a house of prayer. So we're going to turn Church on the Hill into a house of prayer. I thought you would be excited. 2023, we're going to turn Church on the Hill into a house of prayer. If prayer can be at the center of what we do, then the center will hold and everything will fall into place. Let me repeat this. If prayer can be at the center of everything that we do, then the center will hold and everything will fall into place. Things fall apart because the center cannot hold. If things are falling apart in your marriage, in your family, in your business, church, check whether the center is still holding. If prayer can be at the center of what we do in 2023, then everything will fall into place. In times like this, we need an anchor. In times like this, we need a rock. Jesus Christ, the solid rock. I've decided to obey God because I understand that our miracles and our breakthroughs are connected to our obedience. This is what Master Chaba was saying. Mama Tulu came and emphasized the issue of obedience. Our miracles, our breakthroughs are connected to obedience. The scripture that Manqoba read when he was introducing me about Naaman. He got his breakthrough when he stopped complaining and started obeying. Hear me, child of God. You will receive your breakthrough when you stop complaining and start obeying. You will receive your miracle when you stop analyzing and start obeying. When it comes to the things of God, you must not be a scientist, an analyst. You must obey. The Bible says, he who observes the clouds does not plant. Because it says, the way things look, there is no way I can receive my breakthrough. There are two spiritual things or principles that God rewards handsomely. The two are faith and obedience. If you want to experience the supernatural in your life, you need faith and obedience. If you want the supernatural to intervene in your life in 2023, you must believe in God, but also you must obey God. Abraham obeyed when he was told in Genesis 22 to give with his only begotten son, Isaac. And to this day, his obedience is the foundation upon which the success of his descendants is built. It's important for you to get this one. When he was told by God to obey, he did. And to this day, his obedience is the foundation upon which the success of his descendants is built. If you want your children and your grandchildren and your grandchildren to be continue to be blessed even when you are dead, you must obey God today. I say you must obey God today. And in 2023, we're going to obey God and we're going to walk by faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of what you do not see. And without faith, you cannot please God. 2023, we're going to please God by walking by faith. We're going to overcome through prayer and fasting. I said through prayer and fasting. If you love food, you are in a wrong church. In 2023, we're going to feast less. We're going to party less because your problems require less feasting and more fasting. I say they require less feasting and more fasting. The people that you compete with in business, Baba Peitile already. Bagabile already mathenjwa bagabile already laba buya khona abanye sekhona bakufake la ba ready for 2023 but I've come to prophesy that as church members we're going to pray and we're going to fast. I don't hear you. I say we're going to pray, we're going to fast. I don't hear you. We're going to pray, we're going to fast. Oh God, don't worry, yours is just to believe. You don't need to understand. This is what Mangoba was saying. Trust the process. 2023, we're going to reclaim our territories through prayer and fasting. Say 2023, we're going to reclaim our territories through prayer and fasting. If there are things that were taken from you, you don't need to be soft, be wild, just push it out. If there are things that were taken from you the previous years, as we pray and fast, I believe with all of my heart that God will begin to restore. I say God will begin to restore. I say God will begin to restore. If you believe it, rise on your feet and say hallelujah, and say hallelujah, and say hallelujah. The Bible says when the enemy is caught, he has to repay seven times what he has stolen. Everything that the devil stole from you is coming back multiplied. I say it's coming back multiplied in the name of Jesus. Please take your seats. Prayer and fasting will cause our enemies to scatter. Let God arise and his enemies be scattered. Let God arise and our enemies be scattered. They will come at you one way. They will flee before you seven ways. I see them flee seven ways. I see the enemies of your business flee seven ways. I see the enemies of your family flee seven ways. I see the enemies of your career flee seven ways. I see the enemies of this church flee seven ways. They will flee seven ways. The reason why we have to pray and fast is because prayer and fasting draws us closer to God. There's a song we used to sing when we started preaching. It says, I draw closer to you, oh Lord, my God, I draw closer to you, oh Lord, my God, I draw closer to you. I draw closer to you. I draw closer to you. Oh Lord. You must tell your children as a parent that 2023 we are drawing closer to God. You must tell your business partners that 2023 we are drawing closer to God. We are drawing closer to God. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. And as we draw closer to God, I want you to catch this statement. If possible, you must write it down and frame it. You may not be able to write it down maybe because of the speed, but you can always get it from me or from the leaders in the church. It says, the more we draw closer to God, is the more we forget about things and think about God. And the more we forget about things is the more God gives us more things. If you want more things from God, don't think about the things you want. Think about God. Matthew 6:33 says, but seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added. As you seek God through prayer and fasting, whatever you need shall be added. Hear me. Let us not pursue the additions. Let's pursue the source. Do you get that? Let's not pursue the additions. Let's pursue the source. A fish in the ocean doesn't worry about food. If you have not been joining the 21 days of prayer and fasting, please do. We start again with Mother O, 5 and 6, and again in the evening at 6. Today we are starting our second week of prayer. We're going to seek God first through prayer and fasting. Let's go to Nehemiah chapter 1. Nehemiah chapter 1. I want to take you through the first chapter of Nehemiah this morning in emphasizing the importance of prayer and fasting. We read from verse number 1. The words of Nehemiah, the son of Hakaliah, it came to pass in the month of Shislev, in the 20th year, as I was in Shushan, this is the title, that Hanani, one of my brethren, came with men from Judah. And I asked them concerning the Jews who had escaped, who had survived the captivity, and concerning Jerusalem. He asked them about the Jews and also about Jerusalem. But today, please allow me to ask you about the state of your personal life, the state of your marriage, of your family, the state of your career, your business, the state of your finances, and your health. Maybe as we speak, you might have been told by your doctor that the condition of your health is such that you may not live for 3 years. But I've come to declare that as you seek God in prayer and fasting, He will perform a miracle for you. Today, please allow me to ask you about the state of your children, of your parents, of your siblings. Maybe as we speak, the situation is such that there is no way you can rescue your children from drugs and alcohol and failure. They have gone too deep. But I declare to you that as we pray and as we fast, God supernaturally, in the same way He brought back home the prodigal son, I see your prodigal sons and daughters, siblings and parents coming back home. I say, I see them coming back home. I say, I see them coming back home. I say, I see them coming back home. I don't know whether you understand, but people who know, they are believing God to rescue their children, their grandchildren, their parents, their siblings. They will not be sitting down when I prophesy that I see them coming back. 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 Let me tell you, you don't know pain until you see your child goes down. You don't know what pain is until you see a child you carried in your womb for 9 months, his life going down, and you know that if God does not intervene, it's over. October 2023. I say, as we pray, as we fast, God will be gracious. God will be merciful. God will have compassion on us. In the same way, the prodigal son came back. He took everything. After he had gone to his father, saying, "Father, I have rights too. Give me what belongs to me." And he went into a far country. The Bible says there he wasted his life and his possessions, living wildly. He went down to a point of wanting to eat with the pigs. But the Bible says one day he came back to his senses. I say one day he came back to his senses. Your children in 2023 will come back to your senses. Their children will come back to your senses. Your grandchildren will come back to their senses. Your siblings will come back to their senses. Your parents will come back to their senses. He came back to his senses. And he said, "Here I am suffering, and yet there is abundance." He said, "I will arise and go back to my father." I prophesy, they are rising. They are rising. They are rising. They are rising. They are going back to their families. They are coming back to church. I say they are coming back to church. If you believe it, make some noise and celebrate the goodness of the Lord. Please take your seats. Today I'm asking you about the state of our country, of the economy of our country. We would be lying to ourselves if we don't acknowledge that things are not okay. But only God can save. Only God can deliver. Oh God. Where there seem to be no way, Lord, you know how to make a way, God. Only you, God, can save. Only you, God, can heal. We need God. We need you, God. We need you, God. God, we do. We need you, God. We need you, God. We need you, God. Yes, we do. Come and save us. Come and heal us. Come and deliver us. We need you, God. We need you. We need you. We need you. Yes, we do. God, as we need you. We need you. Hey. We need you. Hey. We need you. We need it, God. We need you. Hey, we need you. Oh, yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do. Yes, we need. are sailing in stormy weather. And therefore we need God more than ever before. If we continue reading, they said to me, the survivors who are left from the captivity in the province are there in great distress and reproach. The wall of Jerusalem is also broken down and its gates burned with fire. This is the state of most marriages, families, careers, and businesses. This is the state of our country. Distress, reproach, depression, mental breakdown, joblessness, escalating crime, alarming corruption, declining economy, compromised leadership, load shedding, and many other ills. And if we think that we can survive with our talent alone, our skill alone, our education alone, our beauty alone, then we are lying to ourselves. We are sailing in stormy weather, and therefore we need God more than ever before. I don't know about you, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. It says, so it was. Go ahead and clap. Go ahead and clap. So it was when I heard these words that I sat down and wept and mourned for many days. I was fasting and praying before the God of heaven. Nehemiah declared prayer and fasting. He said, this situation requires prayer and fasting. He responded to his crisis with prayer and fasting. How do you respond to your crisis? 2023, through prayer and fasting, we're going to respond to every crisis.